Ursa Major. Ursa Major, also known as the Great Bear, is a constellation in the northern sky, whose associated mythology likely dates back into prehistory. Its Latin name means greater, or larger, she bear, standing as a reference to an indirect contrast with nearby Ursa Minor, the lesser bear. In antiquity, it was one of the original 48 constellations listed by Ptolemy, 2nd century AD, and is now the third largest constellation of the 88 modern constellations. Ursa Major is primarily known from the asterism of its main 7 relatively bright stars comprising the Big Dipper, the Wagon, Charles's Wain or the Plough, among others, with its stellar configuration mimicking the shape of the Little Dipper. The general constellation outline often significantly features in numerous world cultures, and frequently is used as a symbol of the North, for example as the flag of Alaska. Also the asterism's 2 brightest stars, named Dubhe and Merak, Alpha Ursae Majoris and Beta Ursae Majoris, can be used as the navigational pointer towards the place of the current northern pole star, Polaris and Ursa Minor. Ursa Major is visible throughout the year from most of the northern hemisphere, and appears circumpolar above the mid-northern latitudes. From southern temperate latitudes, the main asterism is invisible, but the southern parts of the constellation can still be viewed. Appearing in the northern sky, Ursa Major occupies a large area covering 1,279.66 square degrees or 3.10% of the total sky, making it the third largest constellation in the night sky. Eugène Delporte in 1930, who set the official International Astronomical Union, IAU, constellation boundaries, formed a 28-sided irregular polygon, which according to the equatorial coordinate system, stretches between the right ascension coordinates of an and the declination coordinates of plus 28.30 degrees and plus 73.14 degrees. Ursa Major borders 8 other constellations, Draco to the north and northeast, Bootes to the east, Canes Venatici to the east and southeast, Coma Berenices to the southeast, Leo and Leo Minor to the south, Lynx to the southwest and Camela Pardalis to the northwest. The 3-letter constellation abbreviation UMA was adopted by the YAO in 1922. The Big Dipper, a term mainly used in the United States and Canada, Plough and, historically, Charles Wain are often used in the United Kingdom, is an asterism within Ursa Major composed of 7 bright stars, 6 of them of second magnitude or higher, that together comprise one of the best-known patterns in the sky. Like many of its common names allude to, its shape is said to resemble either a ladle, an agricultural plow or wagon. In the context of Ursa Major, they are commonly drawn to represent the hindquarters and tail of the Great Bear. Starting with the ladle portion of the dipper and extending clockwise, eastward in the sky, through the handle, these stars are the following. Except for Dubhe and Alcat, the stars of the Big Dipper all have proper motions heading toward a common point in Sagittarius. A few other such stars have been identified, and together they are called the Ursa Major Moving Group. The stars Merak, Beta Ursae Majoris, and Dubhe, Alpha Ursae Majoris, are known as the pointer stars because they are helpful for finding Polaris, also known as the North Star or Pole Star. By visually tracing a line from Merak through Dubhe, 1 unit, and continuing for 5 units, one's eye will land on Polaris, accurately indicating true north. Another asterism known as the 3 leaps of the gazelle is recognized in Arab culture, a series of 3 pairs of stars found along the southern border of the constellation, from southeast to southwest. The first leap, comprising Nuansi Ursae Majoris, Ilula Borealis and Australis, respectively, the second leap, comprising Lambda and Mu Ursae Majoris, Tanya Borealis and Australis, and the third leap, comprising Iota and Kappa Ursae Majoris, Toledo Borealis and Australis. W. Ursae Majoris is the prototype of a class of contact binary variable stars, and ranges between 7.75 and 8.48. 47 Ursae Majoris is a sun-like star with a 3-planet system. 47 Ursae Majoris b, discovered in 1996, orbits every 1,078 days and is 2.53 times the mass of Jupiter. 47 Ursae Majoris c, discovered in 2001, orbits every 2,391 days and is 0.54 times the mass of Jupiter. 47 Ursae Majoris d, discovered in 2010, has an uncertain period, lying between 8,907 and 19,097 days. It is 1.64 times the mass of Jupiter. The star is of magnitude 5.0 and is approximately 46 light-years from Earth. The star type 3429-697-1, 48 degrees 14 feet 2 inches, located to the east of Theta Ursae Majoris and to the southwest of the Big Dipper, has been recognized as the state star of Delaware, and is informally known as the Delaware Diamond. Several bright galaxies are found in Ursa Major, including the pair Messier 81, one of the brightest galaxies in the sky, and Messier 82 above the Bear's Head, and Pinwheel Galaxy, M101, a spiral northeast of Eta Ursae Majoris. The spiral galaxies Messier 108 and Messier 109 are also found in this constellation. The bright planetary nebula Owl Nebula, M97, can be found along the bottom of the bowl of the Big Dipper. M81 is a nearly face-on spiral galaxy 11.8 million light-years from Earth. Like most spiral galaxies, it has a core made up of old stars, with arms filled with young stars and nebulae. Along with M82, it is a part of the galaxy cluster closest to the local group. M82 is a galaxy that is interacting gravitationally with M81. It is the brightest infrared galaxy in the sky. SN 2014J, an apparent Type Ia supernova, was observed in M82 on January 21, 2014. M97, also called the Owl Nebula, is a planetary nebula 1,630 light-years from Earth. It has a magnitude of approximately 10. It was discovered in 1781 by Pierre Mekin. M101, also called the Pinwheel Galaxy, is a face-on spiral galaxy located 25 million light-years from Earth. It was discovered by Pierre Mekin in 1781. Its spiral arms have regions with extensive star formation and have strong ultraviolet emissions. It has an integrated magnitude of 7.5, making it visible in both binoculars and telescopes, but not to the naked eye. NGC 2787 is a lenticular galaxy at a distance of 24 million light-years. Unlike most lenticular galaxies, NGC 2787 has a bar at its center. It also has a halo of globular clusters, indicating its age and relative stability. NGC 3079 is a starburst spiral galaxy located 52 million light-years from Earth. It has a horseshoe-shaped structure at its center that indicates the presence of a supermassive black hole. The structure itself is formed by superwinds from the black hole. NGC 3310 is another starburst spiral galaxy located 50 million light-years from Earth. Its bright white color is caused by its higher-than-usual rate of star formation, which began 100 million years ago after a merger. Studies of this and other starburst galaxies have shown that their starburst phase can last for hundreds of millions of years, far longer than was previously assumed. NGC 4013 is an edge-on spiral galaxy located 55 million light-years from Earth. It has a prominent dust lane and has several visible star-forming regions. IceWiki 18 is a young dwarf galaxy at a distance of 45 million light-years. The youngest known galaxy in the visible universe, IceWiki 18 is about 4 million years old, about 1,000th the age of the solar system. It is filled with star-forming regions which are creating many hot, young, blue stars at a very high rate. The Hubble Deep Field is located to the northeast of Delta Ursae Majoris. The Kappa Ursae Majoris are a newly discovered meteor shower, peaking between November 1 and November 10. HD 80606, a sun-like star in a binary system, orbits a common center of gravity with its partner, HD 80607. The two are separated by 1,200 astronomical units on average. Research conducted in 2003 indicates that its sole planet, HD 80606b, is a future hot Jupiter, modeled to have evolved in a perpendicular orbit around 5 astronomical units from its sun. The 4 Jupiter mass planet is projected to eventually move into a circular, more aligned orbit via the COSI mechanism. However, it is currently on an incredibly eccentric orbit that ranges from approximately 1 astronomical unit at its apoapsis and 6 stellar radii at periapsis. Ursa Major has been reconstructed as an Indo-European constellation. It was one of the 48 constellations listed by the 2nd century AD astronomer Ptolemy in his Almagest, who called it Arctos Megal. It is mentioned by such poets as Homer, Spenser, Shakespeare, Tennyson and Federico Garcia Lorca, in Song for the Moon. The Finnish epic Kalevala mentions it, Vincent van Gogh painted it. In 2009, the American rock band Third Eye Blind named their fourth album, Ursa Major, after the constellation. It may be mentioned in the biblical Book of Job, dated between the 7th and 4th centuries BC, although this is often disputed. Egypt. The constellation of Ursa Major has been seen as a bear, usually a female bear, by many distinct civilizations. This may stem from a common oral tradition stretching back more than 13,000 years. Using statistical and phylogenetic tools, Julian Dehoy reconstructs the following Paleolithic state of the story. There is an animal that is a horned herbivore, especially an elk. One human pursues this ungulate. The hunt locates or get to the sky. The animal is alive when it is transformed into a constellation. It forms the Big Dipper. In Burmese, Puquintera, pronounced Bizantea, is the name of a constellation comprising stars from the head and forelegs of Ursa Major. Puquin is a general term for a crustacean, such as prawn, shrimp, crab, lobster, etc. In Roman mythology, Jupiter, the king of the gods, lusts after a young woman named Callisto, a nymph of Diana. Juno, Jupiter's jealous wife, discovers that Callisto has a son named Arcas, and believes it is by Jupiter. Juno then transforms the beautiful Callisto into a bear so she no longer attracts Jupiter. Callisto, while in bear form, later encounters her son Arcas. Arcas almost shoots the bear, but to avert the tragedy, Jupiter turns Arcas into a bear too and puts them both in the sky, forming Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. Callisto is Ursa Major and her son, Arcas, is Ursa Minor. In ancient times the name of the constellation was Helike, turning, because it turns around the pole. In Book 2 of Lucan it is called Parasian Hellas, since Callisto came from Parasia in Arcadia, where the story is set. The Odyssey notes that it is the sole constellation that never sinks below the horizon and bathes in the ocean's waves, so it is used as a celestial reference point for navigation. It is also referred to as the Wain. One of the few star groups mentioned in the Bible, Job 9:9-38-32, Orion and the Pleiades being others, Ursa Major was also pictured as a bear by the Jewish peoples. The bear was translated as Arcturus in the Vulgate and it persisted in the KJV. In the Finnish language, the asterism is sometimes called with its old Finnish name, Atava. The meaning of the name has been almost forgotten in modern Finnish, it means a salmon weir. Ancient Finns believed the bear, Ursus Arctos, was lowered to earth in a golden basket off the Ursa Major, and when a bear was killed, its head was positioned on a tree to allow the bear's spirit to return to Ursa Major. The Iroquois Native Americans interpreted Alioth, Mizar, and Alcat as three hunters pursuing the great bear. According to one version of their myth, the first hunter, Alioth, is carrying a bow and arrow to strike down the bear. The second hunter, Mizar, carries a large pot, the star Alcor, on his shoulder in which to cook the bear, while the third hunter, Alcat, hauls a pile of firewood to light a fire beneath the pot. The Wampanoag people, Algonquian, Native Americans referred to Ursa Major as Mask, meaning bear, according to Thomas Morton in the New England Canaan. The Waskawish from Native Americans interpreted the constellation as five wolves and two bears that were left in the sky by coyote. In Hinduism, Ursa Major is known as Saptarshi, each of the stars representing one of the Saptarshis or seven sages, viz. Bhrigu, Atri, and Jairasa, Vishishta, Pulastya, Pulalaha, and Krachu. The fact that the two front stars of the constellations point to the pole star is explained as the boon given to the boy sage Dhruva by Lord Vishnu. In Javanese, as known as Bintang Kartika. This name comes from Sanskrit which refers Kartika, the same star cluster. In ancient Javanese this brightest seven-star star known as Lintangwula, literally means seven stars. This star cluster is so popular because its emergence into the sky signals the time marker for planting. In South Korea, the constellation is referred to as the seven stars of the north. In the related myth, a widow with seven sons found comfort with a widower, but to get to his house required crossing a stream. The seven sons, sympathetic to their mother, placed stepping stones in the river. Their mother, not knowing who put the stones in place, blessed them and, when they died, they became the constellation. In Shinto, the seven largest stars of Ursa Major belong to Aminamina Kanushi, the oldest and most powerful of all kami. In China and Japan, the Big Dipper is called the North Dipper, Chinese, Beidou, Japanese, Hokuto, and in ancient times, each one of the seven stars had a specific name, often coming themselves from ancient China. In Theosophy, it is believed the seven stars of the Pleiades focus the spiritual energy of the seven rays from the galactic logos to the seven stars of the Great Bear, then to Sirius, then to the Sun, then to the God of Earth, Sanat Kumara, and finally through the seven masters of the seven rays to the human race. The Lakota people call the constellation, or Great Bear. In European star charts, the constellation was visualized with the square of the Big Dipper forming the bear's body and the chain of stars forming the Dipper's handle as a long tail. However, bears do not have long tails, and Jewish astronomers considered Alioth, Mizar, and Alkid instead to be three cubs following their mother, while the Native Americans saw them as three hunters. Noted children's book author H. A. Ray, in his 1952 book The Stars, A New Way to See Them, had a different asterism in mind for Ursa Major, that instead had the bear image of the constellation oriented with Alkid as the tip of the bear's nose, and the handle of the Big Dipper part of the constellation forming that line of the top of the bear's head and neck, rearwards to the shoulder, potentially giving it the longer head and neck of a polar bear. Ursa Major is also pictured as the starry plough, the Irish flag of labor, adopted by James Connolly's Irish Citizen Army in 1916, which shows the constellation on a blue background, on the state flag of Alaska, and on the House of Bernadotte's variation of the coat of arms of Sweden. The seven stars on a red background of the flag off the community of Madrid, Spain, may be the stars of the plough asterism, or of Ursa Minor. The same can be said of the seven stars pictured in the bordure azure of the coat of arms of Madrid, capital of that country. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.